Matthew VanDyke is the founder of Sons of Liberty International, a security company that trains vulnerable people to defend themselves from terrorists and insurgents. Right now, he's in northern Iraq preparing to train the Christian community there to fight ISIS. He joins us now by Skype. Matthew, thank you so much for joining us on the broadcast. What led you to start Sons of Liberty International?
Well, I had a lot of experience in the region, spent many years here, including in Iraq. And after the deaths of my friends, James Foley and Stephen Sotloff, who were beheaded by ISIS, I decided to take what I had learned over here and the contacts I had and put them together to see what we could do for the Christian community to help them fight ISIS.
Tell us about these fighters you are training. Who are they? Where are they from?
Well, we've trained a battalion of around 330 fighters of the Nineveh Plains Protection Unit. They're Christian fighters. They're from northern Iraq, north of Mosul, and Mosul and an area called Karakulsh. It's a largely Christian area. They're very brave, very determined. They've lost a lot, though. You know, the Christian population in Iraq has gone from around 1.3 million in 2003 to 300,000 or less now, and they're really fighting for the future of Christianity in Iraq.
You started the Sons of Liberty International. My understanding is that you started it with your own money. It is a nonprofit group. Where do you get your funding?
Well, we get our funding from Christians around the world who show their support. They go to the website at sonsoflibertyinternational.com, and they make a contribution. And we've really crowdfunded the war against ISIS and the defense of Christianity in Iraq. We're giving everyday people the opportunity to be a part of a movement. And rather than just click like on Facebook or retweet something, they can actually give a little money and have a tangible effect on the ground for Christians.
What qualifies you, Matthew, to do this kind of training? To tell us your own background.
Well, I have a master's degree in Middle East Security Studies from Georgetown University. I spent around 7 years now, 7 or 8 years in the region, in North Africa and in the Middle East. I fought in the war in Libya to help overthrow Muammar Gaddafi. During the time, I was wounded and captured and spent nearly 6 months as a prisoner of war. I escaped prison with other prisoners and returned to combat on the front lines until that war was over. I've spent a lot of time in this region, had a lot of contacts, and most importantly, though, the people that we get as trainers, who are the real men and women behind this effort, are former U.S. military veterans. So we give them the opportunity to volunteer and come over. We've had over 300 volunteers apply so far. We have training starting in just a few weeks from now. And we really need the public support to keep going.
What part, Matthew, does your Christian faith play in motivating and encouraging you to do what you do?
Well, this is something that you know, I have gotten more comfortable speaking about. But to me, religion became a very personal thing that got me through when I was a prisoner in Libya. Like, I was in solitary confinement for nearly 6 months. I had nobody to talk to except for God. The only thing that got me through that every day was prayer. I was stuck in a room, literally staring at a wall for half of a year with just conversations with God. So that really grew my faith, and I see the faith, that same level of determination and that same reliance on God in the eyes of every Christian here in Iraq that's struggling to survive against the face of these just brutal terrorists. They've kidnapped Christian women, sold them into sexual slavery, forced them to be jihadi brides, slaughtered Christians, taken over their homes, destroyed monuments and churches of Christianity that have been here since the first few centuries of the faith. So, you know, faith is what's driving everybody here. Anybody who's in Iraq is here and working with Christians is because they believe in the Christian cause and because they believe that they're doing the right thing.
Matthew, how would you assess the Obama administration's efforts to protect minority faith groups like the Christians, the Yazidis, including Shia Muslims? How would you assess his efforts right now?
I would say, what efforts? These communities cannot rely on people from other groups to defend them. When ISIS attacked Christians, the Peshmerga withdrew in the middle of the night. Christians woke up the next morning and found ISIS outside their homes. Groups will not defend other groups in Iraq. People have to be given the means to defend themselves. The Obama administration is giving support to the Iraqi army, to the Peshmerga of Kurdistan, and even to Sunni tribesmen to defend themselves, all Muslim groups, but he's given absolutely nothing to Christians. The Christians raise money from their community, from their diaspora around the world. We're starting to supply them with things in addition to providing completely free training to them. They have nobody to rely on. The government does nothing for them. And I just don't understand.
And to that point, obviously, you see what's happening here in the United States politically and so forth. But can you speak to the Christians in America and the churches? Do you get a sense in northern Iraq that the church also is silent to the plight of Christian suffering in Iraq and across the Middle East?
Yes, I think the church is generally silent on Christian persecution around the world. We haven't seen this level of Christian persecution in many centuries. You have attacks happening in Pakistan, twice now in Libya, Nigeria with Boko Haram, and here in Iraq and elsewhere. It seems to be accelerating. It's happening all over the world. And the Christians need to stand up and defend the faith and defend their own people here before it's too late. We're seeing Christian populations being wiped out, driven out, and abused at the hands of usually Islamic extremists all around the world now.
Matthew VanDyke is the founder of Sons of Liberty International, speaking to us via Skype from northern Iraq. Matthew, thank you so much for all you're doing. Please keep safe, and our prayers and thoughts continue to be with those believers, not just in Iraq, but across a large swath of the Middle East suffering for their faith. Matthew, thank you so much for joining us on the broadcast.
Thank you for having me.